Hello everyone, this is Dr. Savita MB speaking on the in continuation with the corrosion science and metal finishing. This is my third video where I will be discussing on the types of corrosion. Okay, corrosion, as we have already discussed, it is the destruction of the metal and then loss of the metal through the environment attack. Types of reactions of corrosion we have discussed in our previous video. Now, types of corrosion, there are two types of corrosion: differential metal corrosion, differential aeration corrosion, and also there is one more type of corrosion, that is stress corrosion. But in the here I will be discussing more on differential metal corrosion and differential aeration corrosion. The first one, differential metal corrosion, the name itself tells. That is when two different metals, differential metals, two different metals are directly in contact, the corrosion that happens is called as differential aeration, metal corrosion. Okay, because you know when two different metals are indirectly in contact, one of the metal will be anode, one of the metal will be cathode. Corrosion environment anyway is there, corrosion takes place. Okay, so what is the main driving force? As you know, the out of the two metals, one of the metal will have higher reduction potential, the other one will be having lower reduction potential. The lower reduction potential will be acting as anode, the higher reduction potential metal will be acting as cathode. It will be the anode that is lost. Okay, and this type of corrosion is also called as galvanic corrosion because a galvanic cell is formed. Right, the reactions, it is once the anode and the cathode regions are formed, you can see at the anode metal dissolves or undergoes oxidation, liberating electron. In the environment, there will be some ions. Depending upon the environment, the cathode reaction varies. We have discussed about this. One of the main reaction is in the absence of oxygen, liberation of hydrogen, or in the presence of oxygen, absorption of oxygen will be the main reactions. Okay, so depending upon the environment and depending upon the metal, the corresponding cathode reaction takes place. Right, some ions in the atmosphere will be demanding for electrons. Okay, example is when zinc is in contact with copper, zinc has lower reduction potential, copper has higher reduction potential. Zinc will undergo corrosion, whereas copper does not undergo corrosion, it is unaffected, right? Therefore, if at all you want to preserve or protect copper, you can keep it in contact with zinc. So until zinc is in contact with copper, copper is protected because it is cathodic. Okay, next is differential aeration corrosion, right? So there's one example shown. Okay, here differential aeration corrosion, the name itself here, again the name itself is self-defining. See, differential aeration, where there is difference in the concentration of the oxygen or air, right? So that is called differential aeration corrosion. See, as we have discussed in the reactions of corrosion, in the cathodic reaction, in the presence of oxygen, there is a cathodic reaction which is the absorption of oxygen. So when if at all a metal surface is exposed to different concentration of oxygen, right, so the metal which is exposed to more oxygen concentration will absorb oxygen, and the absorption of oxygen is a cathodic reaction. Therefore, the more oxygenated area or more aerated area will act as cathode, and the other, that is the poorly oxygenated area or the less aerated area, will act as anode. And the moment anode and the cathode regions are formed, the anode undergoes oxidation. You can see the reaction here. Okay, some typical examples we can see. See here, a nail is struck in the wall, right? Now, the part of the nail which is inside the wall is exposed to less oxygen compared to the part of the nail which is outside the wall, right? So the part which is outside the wall is more oxygenated or more aerated, therefore it is cathode. The part which is inside the wall is less aerated, and that part is the anode, and the part which is inside the wall is actually undergoing the corrosion and is actually becoming brittle or it is being lost, right? In a previous video, we have come to know that the anode undergoes oxidation, cathode undergoes reduction, whereas the corrosion product is deposited near to the cathode. Okay, therefore sometimes seeing the products deposition of the product, it we sometimes feel that it is the this part which is undergoing corrosion, but actually the inner part, that is which is less oxygenated, is actually undergoing corrosion. It is only the deposition of the corrosion product. Okay, so next example is see this iron gate. A part is inside, see, inside the frame. The part which is inside the frame is actually less oxygenated, and that part will be the anode. The outer part which is more oxygenated is the cathode. The outer part actually is not undergoing corrosion, but it is only the deposition of the rust. Therefore, it is an example for differential aeration corrosion, where the same metal is exposed to different oxygen concentration. Right. Another example is, see, this is a paper clip gem pin, which is it is clipping up several papers. See, you can see that it is being rusted. Now this is an alloy steel, but still it is undergoing corrosion. Okay, so the part which is inside the paper pages is actually exposed to less oxygen concentration, and therefore that is the anode. Whereas this part, it is only the deposition of the corrosion product. This part is cathode, right? Here also, see, corrosion products only can be seen outside. It's a pipe which is covered by dust, and you can see the corrosion product deposition. Okay, but this part is actually exposed to more oxygen concentration. Actually, this part is a cathode. The inner part is actually undergoing corrosion. This is only the deposition. Okay, now with this, there are two types of differential aeration corrosion: water line corrosion and pitting corrosion, right? First one is water line corrosion. See, whenever a metallic structure is half immersed in water, that means if it is any tank which is half filled with water, or metallic structure like, see, you, here you can see a ship. In a ship, half of the part or some part of the ship is always below the water, right? So the metallic structure which is half immersed in water, a part which is below the water level is exposed to less oxygen compared to the part which is above the water level, right? So that itself is sufficient to start the corrosion, because the part which is above the water level is exposed to more oxygen, so that part will be absorbing oxygen, and absorption of oxygen is mainly cathodic reaction. So the part which is below the water level will be the anode. Okay, here also the part of the ship which is below the water level is actually undergoing corrosion, because it is the anodic with respect to the part which is exposed to more oxygen, right? Therefore, that is why this type is called as water line corrosion. Just below the water line, the part is metal is exposed to less oxygen, and just above the water line it is exposed to more oxygen, right? So along the water line, the corrosion product goes on getting deposited, right? You must have seen in this, any iron tanks or steel tank, if you fill water, half fill, it is half filled with water and kept for a long time, you can see a brown rings formed along the level of water. Okay, that is because of the deposition, right? Somewhere in the middle of the filled water thing, here corrosion, there is no difference in the oxygen concentration. Or somewhere in the bulk, here also there is no oxygen concentration difference. It is only along the water line, water level, just above more oxygen, just below less oxygen. Okay, therefore water line corrosion occurs. See, here there is an example for the ship, see, which is half immersed in water, half immersed in, say part of the level which is below the water level. Okay, now the reason is, as you know, the more oxygen concentration, a concentrated area will absorb oxygen, it will liberate anions, okay, the product of cathode reaction. This metal which is less exposed to oxygen will liberate electrons. Metal ions and the hydroxyl ions combine to form the corrosion product. Okay, the next one is pitting corrosion. Right, now pitting corrosion, let us assume this is a metallic structure. Okay, there's a small impurity drop. Let us assume this is a dust particle or a water droplet or a oil droplet. A small dust particle is settling on the metal surface. Okay, so that small area which is below the dust particle, the area which is below that dust particle is exposed to less oxygen when compared to the rest of the area. Therefore, that small area which is exposed to less oxygen will be the anodic part. The entire rest, large area of cathode is present. As we have already discussed, if the anodic part is, anodic area is less compared to the cathodic area, then corrosion reaction will be very fast, because large cathode means large demand of electron. Small anode means small supply area. So to satisfy the large demand of electrons, anode will have to accelerate its rate. Okay, therefore corrosion reaction will not only start, it will be accelerating. Okay, so this type of corrosion is just like digging a pit, right? That's why the name pitting corrosion. Just below the anodic part, see, it is going on getting corroded, and generally this type of corrosion goes unnoticed, because it starts at a very small area and it goes very fast. Okay, pitting corrosion. So corrosion rate is very fast. Not only fast, it is accelerated reaction, because small anode has to satisfy the demand of electrons. All right, so this is this type of corrosion is very localized. It starts at a very small area, and generally it is difficult to detect pitting corrosion, and we can only detect when the entire structure collapses. Right, so this is pitting corrosion. The region, portion of the metal which is covered by the impurity or the dust, is less aerated, therefore it is the anode region. The region which is not covered by any impurity is exposed to more oxygen, therefore it acts as the cathode. Right, so again here we have already discussed that the ratio of anodic to cathodic is lesser than 1, therefore corrosion rate is very high. Okay, once a corrosion product is formed, later this corrosion product itself acts as a impurity and continues the corrosion. Okay, the pit grows and ultimately the entire structure collapses. Right, so this is sometimes pitting corrosion also occurs due to the peeling up of the small coating. Right, so suppose if you are giving a coating of tin over iron, and iron is not undergoing corrosion because it is not exposed, and suppose it is coated with the tin, tin will be acting as a protective barrier. Right, if a small area of tin is exposed, or it is peeled off, then it will be exposing a small iron anode, so it will give small anode, large cathode, and again corrosion reaction will be very high. Okay, loss of the corrosion will be more, the loss of the metal will be more. Okay, so the next video I shall be discussing on the control of corrosion. Thank you.